When I get overwhelmed in my business, which is like at least once a week, I think I can do three things here. I can automate it, eliminate it, or delegate it. But when you're early on in your business, there's not a whole lot of people around for you to delegate to. So you have to automate a lot of things and a lot of different workflows. In today's video, I'm going to take you behind the scenes of our one-on-one client workflow system and process using a hybrid of both Honeybook and Trello. Hey guys, welcome to another episode. My name is Ashlyn Carter. I'm the calligrapher and copywriter behind the brand Ashlyn Writes. I help creative entrepreneurs like you work from a place of rest, not hustle. We have a ton of different workflows in my business, and I'm gonna take you behind the scenes and show you those today, but I wanna explain the reasoning on that. If I have to do something two or even three times, I'm gonna put it into some type of a workflow or an itemized list of the order and the steps that I'll do things in. I am an organized, forgetful person, it's a thing, and I also wanna make sure that I really deliver and give people a high-end client experience. I can do that best when I don't leave out a step, and so that's why I create a lot of different workflows. If you've never taken the time to outline your workflow system before for any of your client services, what I recommend is grab a pad of paper and a pen, and the next time that you have to do a repetitive system in your business, take time, pause between each step, and write out what you did. It takes a lot more time the first time that you do this, but I promise it speeds things up in the long run. Today, we're gonna go behind the scenes of both Honeybook and Trello because they use a combination of those, and this is the reason why I do that. I really don't think that there's gonna be one project management system or one CRM tool that is gonna have every single bell and whistle that you've ever dreamed up in one place. That's just not gonna happen unless you're a software developer yourself. So I think the secret is to pick one that works really well, that has most of all of the features and the things that you need and make it work for you. That means you're gonna have to spend some time and you're gonna have to put in a little elbow grease to make it work for you. But again, like workflows, in the long run, it pays off. So Trello is the project management tool that we use in our business that pretty much operates as the company's like business brain. Let's go to the computer and I want to show you behind the scenes of what that looks like for us. So here's a peek into our Trellos. Like I said, there's lots of different tools out there, but this is the one that we went with. And if you're interested after seeing this, I'm gonna link below the other Trello training videos that I have. Some of them even include a swipe where you can grab and replicate the board to your own account. But this is, in a nutshell, kind of ground zero of our business. Sweet Sarah's photo came up. You can add photos to them, and hers is always the only one, and I love it. But we keep tons in this company guidebook board, but you can see we have a lot of videos. I'm gonna take you behind the scenes of the current client ones in just a moment. We couple that with Honeybook, which is the client relationship management tool. So I wanna show you a little bit of what that looks like inside the interface as well.
This is a little peek inside what is essentially ground zero for Honeybook. So when you pop in, this is what you see first. And what I like is that it is a great visual representation of people moving along in your sales process from inquiry all the way to project completion. And this is what Honeybook calls the pipeline. So when you hit the projects tab, this is how you see all of your active projects. It is nice and clean right now, which I like. I can easily see when we have inquiries, people that need to be responded to. Something else that I've also liked is the ability to customize it, which I totally recommend. So a couple of things that I added were this little bucket, kickoff call schedule, that's your inquiry consult call. And I also added a tab, look how many are in there, to add people to my portfolio. Clearly, I tend to not be so good at that, so that can be a great reminder. So the way that you add those in is by clicking add stage. You can add a lot, which is great. You can also move them around, which I really like. But this is how we run ours. The thing that I'm gonna talk a little bit more about in this video is how certain processes are automated. So for example, when somebody moves from proposal sent, the minute they sign it, Honeybook pops them in here. The minute they pay, Honeybook pops them in here. And then it's up to me to move them on, which I can set up workflows to do. And I'm gonna show you about that in just a sec.
Now, before I dig into our one-on-one client process, I recommend that you set up three things inside Honeybook first: your email signature, your packages, and your contract agreement templates. First up, your email signature. Let me show you how to set that up back at the computer.
Updating your email signature is pretty easy. You're gonna pop over to Tools, which is where all of these templates and workflow-ish things live. And I'm gonna pop over here and come down to email signature. Now, right now, at the time of recording, you when you pull this drawer out, you can always see that number of templates that you have. Honeybook only has one option, but that's okay. We essentially use it as the team's update, and everybody can put their sign off above this signature. The marketing nerd in me wants a face, so we've got some trust factor with the eyes. That was really nerdy, but you get what I'm saying. I do pop in here once a week and pop in the upcoming dates that I'll be in and out of the office, just so our clients are aware of that at all times. But yeah, that is how email signature works.
Next up, all of your services packages. These are the one-on-one offerings that you're providing as a business.
Now, I recommend going ahead and filling out these, because when you go to send your agreement or your proposal to someone, you have the opportunity to just click on these and they auto load, which is fantastic. You don't have to type it out every single time. My recommendation on this is to go ahead and Mac Daddy it out, include some good copy, because when your client gets this, it pops up, for lack of a better word, kind of like a line item receipt. So you're able to, especially for those of us that have one-on-one price points that are kind of high, you're able to explain again and remind your client what all they get inside. I do like that you can add photos. That's kind of fun. And you can include the price points, which is great. Pull this drawer out again. I wanted to show you this one as well. So I like that you can remind your client what all they get when they pay that big number, because that can be a little bit scary.
Finally, you're going to want to go ahead and load in all of your different contract agreements. Now, we have lots of different ones of these, as you can see here on the screen, both for JV partnerships, all of our copywriting services, and even different types of calligraphy services. I'm going to go ahead and itemize for our one-on-one clients the things that I'm going to need our brides to give us when it comes to dropping us their invitation list and that kind of thing. For contract agreements, I use the Contract Shop, which was created by my friend Christina, and I've helped and worked with her to create a copywriting template and a calligraphy template. I'm going to link both of those below, so if you're interested, you can check them out. But if you have any other kind of creative small business, I would recommend looking at her Contract Shop and seeing what kind of templates she has available, because then you can just pop those into Honeybook. Okay, those three things are set up, so you're mostly ready to roll. Now, the first thing that happens, the first step of the workflow, is when your client fills out the contact form that you can either embed on your website or provide to them in a separate link. Whatever you choose there, you're gonna wanna make sure that as the business owner, you've greased the slide. You've made it really easy for clients to come into and step into your workflow. After they fill out that form, you're gonna wanna send them your brochure. Now, you can use this inside Honeybook, which I have used in the past, but I also switched recently to using a kind of PDF client magazine. I wanted a little bit more of a high-end branded experience, but both have worked well for me in the past. If they like what they see in the brochure or the magazine, they're given access to an Acuity scheduling link. This is a link that they can click on and have access to the parts of my calendar that I've opened up for them, so we don't have to do the whole back and forth trying to figure out a time that works best. I also like this because I live in Atlanta, which has a tendency for a little bit of traffic. I don't do one-on-one consults in person, because if I left the office, I would be gone for hours given the traffic. So this is a way that I'm able to speed up my workflow as well. After this step, I manually move them to the kickoff section here, and I'm going to show you a few more ways that you can automate this back behind the scenes in Honeybook in just a moment. Next comes the whole proposal, agreement, and contract part of the workflow. And here you just update that template that we pre-populated in Honeybook earlier. You're gonna add your project, update costs, update the payment plan to whichever one your client would like, and go ahead and review your contracted agreement. When you get ready to send this, you're going to use an email template that you've already loaded in as well. I am also a nut about email templates. Like I told you before, if I'm going to do something twice or three times, I'm gonna go ahead and put it into a template. I think we have about 31 different email templates in Honeybook, and that's not including the ones that we use to manage the Gmail inbox. If you're interested in those, I have a few packs of them in the Ashlyn Wright shop, and I'll link that below as well. Honeybook automatically moves then here from proposal signed to retainer paid, and then you're ready to go ahead and start working. Now, here's where my own workflow system takes a little bit of a bent, and you're gonna see Trello come into play, the tool that I showed you first. Now, I am a little bit type A, if you didn't already guess, and we have 32 steps for each of our big packages. You can put all of those into Honeybook, but what I wanted to do is pull it out and put it in Trello because we keep so much of our business there as well.
Once a client gets to this spot in the pipeline, I come over and do this. Essentially, we have all of our workflows, all the processes that we have in the business over here. And so all I'm gonna do in Trello to duplicate this and add it to our current clients board is first come over to the current clients and then just pretend to make this. Client name, and then now I'm gonna come over back to here and to copy. And instead of copying it to this board, I'm gonna move it to this, create. All right, and then I'll pop over here and yep, there it is, ready to go. So we can come in here and then start checking off things on the list.
So back to Honeybook, the other tools that we'll use there once we're moving through that workflow that I showed you are both the questionnaire and the timeline. We have lots of different questionnaire templates built out and already housed in Honeybook, and we use those at different points during that whole workflow that I showed you over in Trello. So say, for example, we're getting to the point in the calligraphy client process where we need all the names of the bridal party and we need the composers for the different parts of the wedding ceremony. We're going to request that information come through in a questionnaire. After that, it's really just a matter of moving through that workflow that I already showed you in Trello and ticking off every step of the process. After all this, there's a part of the process that I feel pretty strongly about, and that is the offboarding process. Whether you're sending a goodbye kit to your client or sending some sort of testimonial request that you have automated to send out in Honeybook about a month after you work together, I just recommend that you have some sort of punctuation mark at the end of your process. I have definitely worked with clients in the past where I've been the client and you have that moment where you think, are we done yet? Are we still going? And so I really recommend having some way to button up, tie up with a nice neat bow the end of your experience. And there you have it. That is how we use our Honeybook and Trello hybrid workflow to service our one-on-one clients. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And as always, I love and welcome your questions, and you can leave those below. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any more of these trainings, and I'll see you back next week.